This case has now been handed over to the Central Bureau of Investigation. There were, you know, lots of questions about whether this sets a precedent that could get tricky going forward. What's your sense of how compelling the arguments were for the Supreme Court to have been handed over this case to the CBI, and what do you see happen from here now? Will there finally be justice? Will this mystery ever be resolved, Karuna?
There are a number of aspects of the judgment that are a little troubling, Rahul. I think the first is the finding that the Bihar police has jurisdiction at all. Because, for example, if you read the judgment, and it's not a long judgment, it's a judgment of 35 pages, and it's very clearly set out what the reasons are. So it doesn't take a specialist constitutional lawyer to read the judgment. I think one question is that under Section 181 of the CRPC has been cited, right? And there it says that one of the grounds for jurisdiction is where the accused is meant to render accounts of the property that is impugned under Section 406. Now, the point is that it is not the accused that was in Bihar, right? It's the parents of the victim, which is a separate issue altogether. The second thing is that the notice issued by the Supreme Court, you will have noticed that it's a single judge that has made the decision, whereas usually it's a division bench that makes the decision, such decisions, right? By a notification dated the 11th of May of this year, the Supreme Court said that there are particular decisions that a single judge may make. A single judge may make a decision on transfer of a case from one place to another. What the judge has quite correctly said is that the transfer jurisdiction refers to the transfer of a case in court, not to the transfer of an investigation. And what he's done is that he's made the decision under 142. So Article 142 of the Constitution of India. Does the single judge then even have the jurisdiction to make such a decision, I think, is a question. Another ground on which the decision has been made is because of the apprehensions voiced by some of the stakeholders. Also, apparently, Ms. Chakrabarty's tweet speaking of a CBI investigation. Now, the Supreme Court has a constitutional bench said that mere apprehension is not sufficient to transfer an investigation from one party to the other. So what worries me very much about this decision is that it leaves it sort of opens the floodgates to people choosing the police force that they wish for, regardless of whether it has any jurisdiction whatsoever or not, firstly. Secondly, there is such damage to public institutions across the board. The Supreme Court has said that the CBI is a caged parrot. There are allegations being made, you know, both ways. There are deep concerns about federalism, I think, that arise from this judgment. And in such a case, therefore, I think that following previous jurisprudence strictly and to a T, and not just in this judgment, because everything seems to be so hotly contested now, that I think textual interpretations of judgments that have come before, of course, applying them to the particular facts, has really become the need of the hour. Now, going forward, one hopes that the CBI will do its job and make sure that the investigation is dealt with in a stringent and forensic and reasonable manner. Okay. One difficulty, I think, is the sort of speaking about the Shiv Sena government, the completely arbitrary allegations against Aditya Thackeray. And if those allegations, I think, come in with limited basis, and we'll see that at the time of the charge sheet, it'll be really sad.